Two of my favorite pedals have been stomped on quite a bit over the years, and they're beginning to do this kind of thing. Now, while stepping on your pedal and kicking it around a bit might be a perfectly acceptable solution for some, I'm gonna see if we can do one better. This pedal obviously cuts out when I step on it. This pedal does a similar thing, except when I step on it, it causes a lot of background static and crackling, until I boot it around a bit. I've tried different cables, I've tried different power supplies, so we're gonna open them up and see if we can fix it. I'm by no means a master tech, but to my eye, nothing looks obviously wrong inside, like loose wires, or discolored or cracked solder joints. So, first, plug in a cable and make sure that the input and output jacks are making solid contact. If one of these connections doesn't look or feel solid, you can bend this piece up until it does. But these feel good and they also look clean, there's no gunk or corrosion on the jacks. We'll also check the power jack, which feels and looks okay. So I'm thinking the switch is the problem. Let's open it up and see if we can find what's going on. Now, you might ask, why not just replace the switch? Well, for one, what's the fun in that? Two, the switches I was looking at online are mostly cheap no-name switches, and I figure the quality of the switch in this pedal is probably better than anything I would order online. Also, thirdly, the soldering job in this pedal is a lot better than anything I'm gonna do. So, I figure, let's first see if it's fixable. Find a wrench to loosen the nut on top. For this pedal, 14mm fit. While you're loosening the top, hold the switch from the back just so it doesn't spin around and break all the connections. Then slide the switch out through the back. I removed this nut, but it turns out you really don't need to take it off. There are four tabs here, two on either side of the switch. I was able to pry these tabs back with a razor. In case the razor slips, which it will, I used pliers instead of my hand to hold the switch steady. Just be sure not to squeeze too tight or rotate the pliers, which could damage the threads on the switch. Once the tabs are loose, you can remove the top of the switch. Take care not to lose the spring inside it. Lift off this white plastic cover, and underneath, you'll see the switch contacts. These contacts have notches on either side of them to keep them in place. You can flip these up with a small flathead and then tip the switch to drop them out. There might be some grease in here that gets them a little stuck, so just take your time. Now, these contacts and really all the parts look okay, but there is some grease on them and maybe there should be, but possibly the grease has worked itself where it shouldn't and it's causing bad contact. Again, I'm no master tech, just guessing. So I'm gonna wipe the parts clean or clean-ish and then spray them with a contact cleaner and lubricant that I have on hand. Quick tip, you might want to put everything in a plastic cup first. I almost blew all the parts off the table with the spray can, and of course, you don't want to lose anything. Now we'll put it all back together. Drop the contacts back in and use a small flathead to align the notches so they sit correctly. Then drop in the plastic piece. Align the spring and the button so the metal tabs line up where they were when we started. Now, I used pliers to squeeze and press the tabs back into place, but spend some time here, or come up with a better way to squeeze the tabs, because the top needs to stay tightly in place. If you put the pedal back together and the switch isn't clicking, the top likely is not tight or secure with the plastic housing. Then, put the first nut back if you removed it. Again, turns out there was no need to remove this. Slide the switch back into place, and tighten the nut on top. Well, let's plug it back in and see what happens. So, success on both of these pedals. If this didn't work for you, or if you're just not excited about pulling the switch apart, try soldering in a replacement switch. When ordering a switch, be sure to get the correct type of switch, on-off or momentary, depending on your pedal. Also, be sure the switch looks exactly like the one you have, with the same number of contacts on either side. Also, before you start unsoldering things, take a picture of the old switch, and that way you can make sure you wire up the new switch exactly like the old one. Hopefully this helps if you're having a similar issue with your pedal. If so, be a pal and subscribe, and let me know below. Thanks for watching.